back to expand it. Did you ever feel like you have a lot of time but don't know what to do with it? This year is very specific in this regard. Just a quick onboarding for those who are listening from the future. 2020 is the year we are writing now, has left a significant mark on humanity. As of writing, we are still in the midst of fighting the pandemic, self-distancing, restricting social gatherings, and for those who can, working remotely. Restrictions enter many aspects of life, one of which is taking holidays, for example. Employers can be quite instrumental about holiday consumptions.
You must take a vacation, you must have fun, you must enjoy life.
And as traveling to touristy destinations is not advised, many are left with the options either staying at home or traveling locally. Not sure how you feel about traveling for the sake of traveling or spending holidays where you were working remotely from. That does not really sound attractive or appealing for me. So I revised an earlier idea of mine, dug up two bikes no one was looking at for years now, onboarded my dad, and set out to attempt what very few did in a long time now. We were basically building a recumbent bike. Countless hours went into the research, planning, and visualization, and once the idea crystallized in my head, I set out to source the materials. This scratched up grasshopper of a frame is going to be the main part. I decided to use this full suspended mountain bike as a donor bike. Earlier plans were to build around this mountain bike, but due to several technical issues, this low-hanging fruit of an idea was quickly abandoned. Can you guess what might have been the reasons? Here are some reference bikes which we sourced from the internet. These were kind of instrumental to the final design that we ended up with. You can see they all have reclining chairs, rear suspension, and front drive. And this is what I cooked up in Photoshop. So that's a benchmark for us. And here we can see some of the challenges. First, we had to resize the rear fork. It had to be shrunk so it fits a front tire. Here we see the front fork, which was expanded to accommodate the rear part of the mountain bike. You can see the entire rear part of the frame, including the braking system, was installed. Here we see the rear suspension, and there it is, the suspension installed on the grasshopper. So this is what we came up with so far, and if we couple it with a skateboard, what's gonna be the result? So this is what we came up with. Here you can see the seat is still suspended, and in this little video you can see my father testing the bike, where he very soon discovered that the seat cannot be suspended because it's too wobbly. And there he goes. This seat really had to be fixed. Suspension cannot be really used right there. So those are the things that we attached. And this bike is still not ready, it's still not finished. But without further ado, let's have a look at the maiden ride. We'll be right back. That's all for now. Hope to see you again next time. Bye-bye.